Anna Meares, from a 12-year-old falling in love with cycling in Rockhampton to the world's very best. Anna Meares really is a world beater, and cycling in Australia is poorer for her retirement. But we would like to pay tribute to her tonight, and we turn to Laura Petrie for a song and a video montage of Anna's great career. I failed you. I probably should have sent you an SMS earlier and told you not to wear mascara.
Yeah. That would have been a good tip, Kate.
Yeah. It's pretty emotional for everybody in the room to watch your career in pictures.
Yeah, very much so. I mean, for me even,
And you were there for all of it.
I was there for all of it. I mean, I was a person doing it, and you spend so much time looking forward and planning and striving to be better than you've been previous, and you don't often look back. You know, I know that I have achieved some really incredible things and done some amazing things with the support of truly incredible people. That's probably the first time I've really looked back on it like that.
Yeah. It's and everybody in this room would have a favourite moment from your career. It's quite hard. I do have a favourite, but I won't ruin it in case it's the same as yours. Do you have one that stands out above? We don't have all night,
I know.
Read out all of them.
It's very hard to go past that gold against Victoria Pendleton on home turf in London and the strategy that Gary and the team put together. And certainly the silver medal from Beijing and the recovery process, going through that with Ma. But there was one in Delhi in the quarterfinals of the sprint. I was up against a young Indian woman, and she came up to me and asked for a photo before the race. And her coach came to me, who was an Australian at the time, and said, look, she's been on a bike for 2 months, can you just go easy on her? I said, yeah, we'll go and have some fun. So I made it really, really close and went across the line after the third lap. And look, I give some pretty good death stares at the start of a race.
She does, yes.
And this official got it wrong. He rang the bell at the conclusion of the third lap, so the sprint went for 4 laps. My head turned so fast left, and that guy got the worst death stare in his life, because I then had to drag race her for another lap.
To keep it close. How very diplomatic of you, Anna. How unlike you.
I can be diplomatic.
Anna, when you fell in love with cycling when you first jumped on at about 12 years of age, did you ever imagine you had this career laid out in front of you?
No, not at all. I sucked at it when I first started. I collected the competitors' ribbons. I tagged along with my sister Kerry. I basically went to Mackay for a weekend trip with my friends. That's what kept me on the bike. Until I went to Rockhampton and I met Reg Tucker. And every weekend I went in, he was in my ear. What are you doing? Why aren't you on a bike? I said, I don't know, I might give triathlon a go. And please forgive me for all the triathletes in the room. He goes to me, you know why they call it triathlon? I said, why? He goes, because they've tried all the individual sports and they can't do it. And then I got on a bike.
There's that diplomacy.
Mm. That was Reg Tucker.
Yeah. Well, Anna, you've gotten this far in your career because you've had an incredible amount of support. And I apologise again, you might need to fan your face with your sheet for this one. But one of your dearest friends that's been by your side the whole time is here tonight, Alex Guest. Alex is quite a poet. I'm not sure if you knew. But I've got some words to read out.
Okay, thank you, Brian.
Okay, you better get your tissues ready.
Okay, I'm good.
All right. Anna Meares, a name requiring zero introduction. A stellar career over 15 years, it has been a grand production. The tender age of 12 is where the story made its start. Foundation years in Rockhampton, a country girl at heart. Your first world champs in Melbourne, the Athens Games, then held in Greece. Olympic gold and bronze, a world record, the world to conquer there at your feet. A silver medal in Beijing following 7 months of broken neck recuperation. Successful delivery in London of the infamous Know Thy Enemy operation. Fourth Olympics in Rio, meticulous management of your back, drawing on all your strength to keep your mental preparations bang on track. Determined, focused, stubborn, committed, attributes no one will dispute. Tingles down our spines when you raise your arms in that glorious victory salute. A steely glare that could make your opponent quiver nervously in their pedals. A beaming smile that shone so bright when you were presented with your medals. Three men behind the scenes each pushed you to be your very best. Reggie Tucker, Martin Barras, and the very special Gary West. A role model, a champion, modest and gracious in defeat. Eager anticipation whenever you clipped into your cleats. I knew it had come out. Many special performances, always with your heart worn on your sleeve. Through the triumphs and the hard times, in you, we have always believed. As you move into retirement, your place in history is confirmed. The drone won't be the same without Meares accelerating effortlessly through each turn. From all of us, we thank you. It's been a joy to follow your career. Wherever the ride may lead you, our very best to you, our track queen, Anna Meares.
Thank you, that was beautiful. Thank you, Bridie. She's now a guestie, but she always writes me a 10-point checklist and a poem for every major competition that I go to. And I would love to share some of them with you, but they're probably not appropriate.
Well, Anna, you have friends like Alex that have always been by your side, but a tremendous support team. We named some of the most influential people in your career, but I know that you have a very long list of people to thank tonight.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. I've been very blessed to have around me incredible people, many that you know and many that you don't, from family to friends to sponsors to teammates and staff at the CAHQ program. I could stand here and acknowledge up to 50 people who have had an incredible impact and influence on my life and my career, who've made a contribution to my success. Some who've been there from the beginning, some who are fairly new and some who are no longer part of the team. I could and I have always stood here and thanked those many people for their love and their support, care and belief in me and my goals. But tonight I'd like to just focus on two, Francine and Gary. Many of you won't know Francine, my manager and friend of well over a decade. This high-flying businesswoman based in Dubai loved cycling. Grew up in country Victoria, but never had the opportunity to participate in the sport. To her, I was a hobby, someone she could help with the support of mentoring and management, to bring in corporate financial support based off a plan and a strategy that was not rushed, but carefully built over time. She worked pro bono, excuse me. It's gonna happen. She worked pro bono, never took a cent of anything that she brought me until I could afford to do so, in which case she still wouldn't take any money. Until we came to an agreement that that management fee would go towards Safa, her PA, who supports both of us in the support and care of her young autistic son. Francine stays in the background, never wanting to be in the spotlight. That's why you never hear of her. She doesn't take on anything. She takes on things that contribute to my brand and my person, preferring the quiet knowledge that very few know of her contribution to the building of my brand, the successful sponsorship relationships that have extended the length of my career, and the guidance that she has given me through challenging times to success. She's like a mum to me, loyalty and trust and never needs question. And Gary, or as I affectionately call him, G-Dub, like the motor car, but he's the earlier model. Gary and I have worked together for 8 years. A bit rocky at first, I was unsure if he could take me to a new level and how wrong I was. I always asked him if he was in my corner. Because coaching to me is not just writing a program and making an athlete do it. Coaching, especially at the elite level, is intense and personally intimate. The coach takes on many roles: manager, coach, relationship advisor, parent, supporter, boss, friend, mentor. He's a hard man, but he's an honest man, a caring and supportive man, with rock-solid values. I asked him at the beginning of my career if he was in my corner. It's not even a thought today. For the best part of 8 years, Gary has been like a father to me. We fight. We've had heated moments. We've even gone long periods of time without speaking to each other. But we've both been too stubborn to budge on our position or our feeling. But we've always had respect and we built a friendship for each other and how we operate. Our passions for what we do and where we worked and how desperate we were to succeed and win was what united us, and how painful it was when we didn't. A great man once told me, no one needs to tell a coach or an athlete that the goal is to win medals and to win championships. That's a given. With Gary, that's a given. With me, that's a given. He is as competitive, driven, motivated, desperate, compelled, committed and passionate as I am to succeed and to win, and win we did. In the time that I worked with Gary and Francine, we won 3 Olympic medals, one of those gold, 17 world medals, including 8 gold, 9 gold, forgive me, 5 Commonwealth medals, including 4 gold, and we rode 6 world records. We were uncompromising in our approach. We are a great team. But this team now faces a new challenge, one of a very different level, MND, motor neurone disease. See what I wrote. At the end of this challenge, there will be no medals, there will be no championships, no podiums, and no titles. At the moment, there is limited funding, no cure, and there are no survivors of MND. There are no survivors of MND. Motor neurone disease. It's a name given to a group of diseases in which the nerve cells controlling the muscles that enable us to speak, breathe, and swallow undergo degeneration and die. How many of us did the ice bucket challenge? I know I did. I donated, but I never reconnected or understood MND until now. Gary did not choose MND, MND chose him. But I choose Gary as my friend, and I will support him. Gary knows of the love and the gratitude that I have for all that he's done for me, to the extent very few people know. What I can and will do now is that which he has done for me, and be in my corner, be in his corner. I will support him and his family through this illness and be his voice when he can't speak and his face when he can't confront it. Gary wanted to come up here tonight to say a few words, but as you can understand, it's a very difficult and emotional time for him, and I thank him for being here this evening. What I would like to share is what Gary wanted to say. 8 years ago, Anna Francine and I accepted a series of challenges in an effort to win. Anna's challenge was to win gold in the track sprint at the London Olympic Games and break the dominance of Queen Victoria. Francine's challenge was to ensure Anna was financially secure in order to maintain a single-minded focus. And my challenge was to take Anna to a new level of performance where she would be faster, stronger, and smarter than any of her competitors. All three of us were driven for success and quite quickly understood and accepted all of our roles. We worked as a team, and along the way we became close mates. We chased a dream together and we won. Now, 8 years on, Francine, Anna and I are chasing a new dream with new challenges, and we're committed to bring the same determination to this new cause. We're working to help raise awareness and raise money for research and ultimately a cure for MND. MND is an insidious disease that kills a dozen plus good Australian men and women each week, the average life expectancy of which, once you've been diagnosed, is 27 months. And as Anna previously stated, there are no survivors yet. The economic cost to our society is estimated at $1.1 million, yet only $5,500 is shared each year per head on research. Simply not good enough, and we need your help. Finally, there's no better example of cycling cares than my two former athletes, namely Anna and my close friend Gary Newon, who is here tonight. I'm incredibly proud to have these two in my corner, and I'll ask Anna to provide some details. MND is a global disease which does not discriminate from gender, age, race or religion. And as we know, cycling is one of the world's global sports. And as such, we plan to enlist the stars of our sport here in Australia and overseas to assist our cause. We want to engage and partner with Cycling Australia, the UCI, and teams including our very own Orica Bike Exchange as we extend that to other cycling communities. It doesn't matter where the funds come from, and it doesn't matter who finds a cure. What matters is that a cure is found. And that only happens through raising awareness and the needs for the funds for research. Last week, we launched the first phase of our Cycling Cares campaign on Facebook and our website, all which is linked to the cure for M&D Foundation of Neil Danaher and Ian Davis, from which we have all had wonderful support. And as Neil Danaher said, the medical cycle of identifying something and then bringing it into market will probably mean it'll be too late for me. But I live in hope because the alternative is hopelessness, despair, and darkness. And in the words of G-Dub, hope underpins our existence, our reasons for getting up each day. Life without hope is no life at all. Gary has a mighty fight ahead of him, a challenge few can imagine, let alone comprehend. And on behalf of Francine and Gary, I would firstly like to thank you all for the support you have given me in my cycling career, particularly in the way I've been honoured tonight. But we ask of you for your support to continue in this campaign. All of you here are a part of the wider cycling community and a part of our team. Please help us show that cycling cares and we can continue to ride this together. Again, it's on the Facebook page of Cycling Cares and the website. Thank you very much.